Peace, I'm Tommy Ramirez from the MAAC Community Charter School. A solid education is the backbone of a bright future, and we want every student to have an equal chance to graduate ready to take on the world. But Latinos and other students of color are less likely to have the same opportunities as their peers in school. One of the biggest barriers students of color face is the way they're treated when it comes to discipline. An uneven amount of students of color face suspension and expulsion compared to white students. If a white student and a Latino student get in trouble, the Latino student is often punished longer than the white student, or even recommended for expulsion when the white student isn't. Suspension and expulsion do not promote motivation or education at all. They just lead to students being completely pushed out of the education system. Issues like these leave students outside of the structures that are in place to help them thrive. Without a strong presence in school, there's a much higher chance that they'll end up in the juvenile justice system. This is called the school-to-prison pipeline, a system where students, or certain students, are always set up to fail. Restorative justice can fix this problem by focusing discipline on the person instead of the act. With restorative practices, suspension isn't the answer. Suspensions don't address the problem. It just causes students to fall behind in class, making them lose motivation and becoming even more frustrated. Instead, we can work with the student to create a sense of justice together instead of just sending them home. If the student's disrespectful to the teacher, work with the student to understand what they did, what triggered the disrespect, and how to respond better next time. Basically, how to right the wrong. These practices try to transform students' emotions and their understanding of those emotions, the way they think about things and how they deal with issues. A lot of local justice systems have seen the value in restorative practices, and with some work, any school can start introducing those same methods. You can find trainings in areas that have adopted restorative practices and seen transformative results.